No doubt the Reverend Ainsworth read from Job over the charred corpse of the deacon's boy, to wit, "Blessed be the name of the Lord," or some such comfortless dose of holy writ that winter morning after the house fire put all of the first Congregationalists of Jaffrey Center, New Hampshire, out weeping and gnashing out in the snow, while the Mansett Main Street and Gilmore Pond Road blazed into the early Thursday morning. God's will is done, as often without warning as with one. Either way, revere his laws is cut into the child's monument. To rhyme with a previous sentiment, cease, man, to ask the hidden cause, as if the answers ever were forthcoming. So little is known of young Isaac A. Spofford, his father Eleazar, his mother Mary, his death on the 13th of February in 1788, a brand plucked from the ashes, reads his stone, of Reverend Laban Ainsworth's house, which frames the sadness in the pastor's burning faith in God's vast purposes. As if the boy long buried here was killed to show how God makes all things work together toward some good. And yet the stone's inquiry still haunts. Oh, say, grim death, why thus destroy the parents' hopes, their fondest joy? Or say instead, grim death destroys us all by mighty nature's witless random laws, whereby old churchmen, children, everything, all true believers, all who disbelieve, come to their ashen ends, and life goes on.